A team of astronomers, including some from UMass Amherst, have discovered traces of a huge galaxy never seen before. UMass Assistant Professor of Astronomy Kate Whitaker and postdoctoral fellow Christina Williams at the University of Arizona, both UMass grads, worked together on the project. Carolee McGrath sat down with Whitaker to learn more about the discovery and what it all means.
This was actually an accidental discovery. So we had this program with the Atacama Large Millimeter Array and a totally different science case of an ongoing project we have actually. And so we were looking at the data and we happened to notice this fuzzy blob essentially nearby. And so this is in an incredibly well-studied field. So there's a huge amount of data that exists. And we looked in all of the other data. This includes data from the Hubble Space Telescope from all wavelengths of light, and we couldn't see it anywhere. And so this sort of made us scratch our heads and thought, well, what is this? And what does this mean? And, you know, what have we found here? And so it got more and more interesting, I think, as we went along in terms of, like, figuring out, okay, what are we looking at? Is this an accident? Is it an artifact? Is it actually something we're observing? And it turns out what we discovered was an incredibly massive galaxy. So this galaxy has 100 billion stars in it and even more gas than that. So it's about the size of our Milky Way, but we're seeing it 12.5 billion years ago.
That's hard for people to understand. That's hard for people. So you're just seeing it in prior, I guess, observations. It wasn't there, and now you're seeing it. And
so, it's not that it just came into existence. So the other observations we had were looking at different parts of the electromagnetic spectrum. So looking at light with different energy, and so the reason we didn't see it in the other data that we have is there's two reasons. One, it's incredibly distant from us. So because that light has been traveling for 12.5 billion years. So the universe was only just over 1 billion years old when it was emitted. So it's incredibly distant early in the universe. It's essentially a toddler galaxy, if you will, a very massive toddler galaxy. But it's also very dusty. And so if you combine those two things together, essentially it's hidden from our view in all the other data. So it's not to say that it doesn't exist. It's that we can't see light at any of the other wavelengths. We only see it at the very longest wavelengths because it's so dusty and because it's so distant.
How many galaxies are there?
So that's an interesting question. I don't have an exact answer other than to say trillions. There's trillions of galaxies in the universe. And this galaxy is really interesting because it fits in possibly in a missing piece, something we've been trying to search for but haven't yet been really successful finding in mass. And so what it answers possibly a clue to how galaxies evolve. So how they form, some galaxies form lots and lots of stars very early in the universe, and then something happens to shut them off. And so we're still trying to figure out what it is that happened and why. And this galaxy in particular might explain that transition, and we might be catching it at a phase where it's otherwise totally hidden. You can think of it like an iceberg, right? We're just seeing sort of the tip, and it makes you wonder how many other galaxies are there like this. And can it sort of bring our picture together of the early universe and how galaxies form into the present day universe?
Now, you had mentioned this was sort of an accidental discovery. Just what was your reaction when you realized what you came across?
Probably a little anticlimactic of like, that's probably not real. and I should mention, you know, this is really something that is led by a former UMass PhD student, Christina Williams, Dr. Christina Williams. So she's now a postdoctoral fellow at the University of Arizona. And so she's the one who really actually discovered and saw this fuzzy blob.
Talk a little bit about the radio telescopes that were used in South America. In Chile.
So ALMA is now, in terms of radio telescopes, it's really changing the field, I guess, if you will, because it's so sensitive of a telescope and it has such high spatial resolution. So you can really do new science with it. And so that's why originally we called this an ALMA-only galaxy, because it's really only ALMA that could discover it. Like, with our best data that exists, decades of effort, even with taking data and combining it, we still wouldn't have been able to see this. You need ALMA.
What's next in the research? Will you be looking at, continuing to look at this with ALMA, or is there other technology that will be used?
So I am particularly excited about NASA's next flagship mission. And I think for this particular galaxy, it'll be really interesting to take the James Webb Space Telescope and point at this object and see what we can learn. So James Webb Space Telescope is it's an infrared, so its eyes instead of Hubble is mainly optical eyes, kind of like our eyes see and are sensitive to the colors of the rainbow, for example, and then a little bit into the near infrared for Hubble. James Webb is more taking that and extending to longer wavelengths, so near infrared into mid infrared. Hubble is orbiting in low Earth orbit, so it's not too far from us, and we've had a lot of servicing missions to go and fix it and help it. That's why it's lasted almost 30 years. James Webb instead is going to be launched somewhere we can't go to. It's going to be launched to the second Lagrangian point, and it's going to revolutionize our understanding of the early universe.